Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. It's your girl Netta Ave Maria. Guys, I want to start this video off by saying, first of all, Happy New Year. We're going into 2019. It is literally hours away. So I want to wish many blessings upon you and your family for 2019. I am feeling great about 2019 coming into the new year. Lots of things to look forward to. Just much success and prosperity to everyone. If this is your first time coming to my channel, welcome. I'm gonna need you to go ahead and subscribe though, okay? And then if you are already one of my subscribers, welcome back. I appreciate the love and support. But without further ado, we're gonna go ahead and jump into the video. In this video, we're gonna be talking about things that I hope to see left in 2018 as far as beauty and the makeup industry goes, okay? But where have I been, right? So, do you guys remember Mr. Kitty that I showed you like a few videos back? We got a new cat. The new cat, he kind of ruined my laptop, okay? So, I am without a laptop, and the laptop had all of my editing software on there, and so I'm waiting on my new laptop to get here so that I can continue to upload videos for you guys and edit them because y'all know I can get a little chatty, okay? So there's that, okay? So, but I did want to get a video out before the year was officially done, right? Because I just felt that that was something I needed to do. So, things that I hope to see left in 2018. First of all, can we please leave over highlighting our face, and particularly the tips of our noses in 2018? I would love to see that trend go away in 2019. Some of you guys out here, not everybody, it was trending and that was something, that I was doing, but I'll be glad to see it gone. I don't plan on highlighting the tip of my nose anymore, because it's just crazy, right? So I hope to see that gone in 2019. I know I'm over it. I'm not highlighting the tip of my nose anymore, and just being overly highlighted in the first place. Some of you guys were putting Santa's reindeers out of work. Some of you, and that's not cool, right? Like reindeers out of work, they can't find business because the highlight on your nose was so bright. Santa was good. He didn't need Rudolph. And then when you weren't putting when you weren't putting reindeer out of work, right? We were putting stars out of work. So you know it's something wrong when you getting sued by the stars in the heavens because your highlight is shining brighter than their twinkle, okay? So I'm not gonna ramble, I'm not gonna go on and on about it, but if we could please leave over highlighting our faces, particularly the tips of our noses in 2018, that would be great, okay? Okay, cool. The other thing I hoped to see left in 2018 is butterfly eyelashes, okay? Because butterfly eyelashes, it's not cool. Now, I love lashes, okay? I don't wear them all the time because I just don't feel like every look warrants, false lashes. But when I'm trying to be dramatic and I'm going, for the extra, like right now, I don't have on any false lashes. But let's be honest, some of the lashes I've seen are like over the top, like there is no way your lashes should curl out and all the way up here, okay? It's not cool. I don't think it's cute, so can we please leave the lashes that look like as big as a butterfly's wing in 2018? That would be great. Now, a nice drama lash or day-to-day lash, I'm not saying we should go to sleep on false lashes, okay? I love my false lashes, depending on the look and the mood that I'm in, but just the over huge, eyelashes, I would love to see those stay in 2018 because it looked ridiculous. The next thing I would like to see left in 2018 is us being in the makeup industry, whether it be influencers or just people out and about wearing their makeup in general, being overly made up. Makeup is meant to enhance your natural beauty, not cover up your natural beauty. So when I see people with makeup just caked on their face, and we got rainbow eyeballs, and it looks like I can wipe my finger across your face and just come up with a with all your makeup right there on my finger, it's not flattering. I don't think it's cute, to be just that overly made up. I always have had the opinion that your makeup should be to a point where it's believable, right? Like it's believable. Like I can believe she cute like that, right? But when you're overly made up, it does not look good, in my opinion. It just don't look good. You look fake. And then it starts to look cakey. So if we could leave being overly made up in 2018, that would be great. Now, if you're in a profession where you are creating certain looks for your makeup portfolio, right? You're trying to showcase your work, or you're working the Met Gala, or you're working the runway, or you're doing these looks for the gram, then fine. I get it. I do stuff like that too, where I just do my makeup to showcase my skills. That's different. But where are you going? With rainbow eyeballs and clouds on your eyeballs and sun and stars and sunsets in your eyeballs to the grocery store, or to get gas. Like, no, it's not cute and it's not attractive. But once again, if you're showcasing your work and you're a makeup artist in that sense, and this is your business and your job, and this is how you get yourself out there and promote your work and build your portfolio so that you can target different brands, I get that. I get that. But just, if that's not the case, then ladies, you are beautiful. You're gorgeous. You don't need to be overly made up to the point that you look fake or you look plastic. One girl's opinion, if you want to beat your face to the gods and the heavens, then fine, but in my opinion, it's not cute when you're overly made up. All right? All right. And then lastly, what I would love to see left in 2018 is New Year's resolutions. Who here still makes New Year's resolutions? Not me. I gave up making New Year's resolutions like 5 years ago. And the reason why is because I'd be like, oh, for New Year's, January 1st, I'm gonna eat right, I'm gonna exercise, I'm gonna text people back, I'm gonna make this money, I'm going to be skinny, I'm gonna lose 1,000 pounds. And yeah, come 2019, it's on. And then I would for like a month, and then I'd end up quitting, and all the weight that I lost end up gaining it back, or being so tired from trying to text everybody back and work a full job and attend every PTA meeting at my kids' school and chaperone their field trips and just do everything that I felt like I needed to be doing in the next year, right? Rather than making resolutions and then having them for a month and then not being able to maintain them because you get exhausted from trying to, make all these changes overnight, pretty much, just make lifestyle changes, right? Just, sub a meal for a protein smoothie. Work out once a week or twice a week, depending on your work schedule, how depending your job is. Instead of attending every PTA meeting, try to attend at least two meetings a month. Like make lifestyle changes instead of New Year's resolutions, because New Year's resolutions do not work. They set you up for failure, and then they make you feel bad because you didn't meet the goals that you said you would meet, starting for that new year. And I've been through that. And instead of setting New Year's goals, instead of making New Year's resolutions, I just made lifestyle changes. And then I was able to balance my life and my kids and my work and my personal care with lifestyle changes and not New Year's resolutions. So that's it for today's video, guys. I am hoping to be uploading back more frequently, but unfortunately, like I said, I lost my laptop. I'm waiting for a new one to come, and I look forward to seeing what the new year has in store. I look forward to my business booming, you know, my side business booming. I look forward to prosperity. I look forward to promotions, you know, just, it reminds me of the prayer of Jabez, right? Just increase. You know, I'm looking forward to my increase in 2019, whether it be in my health, my finances, my personal life. That is what I'm looking forward to in 2019. What are you guys looking forward to in 2019? Comment in the comment box and let me know. Well, that's it for today's video. I hope everybody has a wonderful 2019, a happy new year, and I will see you guys in the new year, okay? Bye!